Hello, I'm Dr. Soumya Basanth, working as a cornea consultant at Zamindar's Microsurgical Eye Centre for the past 5 years. Dry eyes is probably one of the most commonest ocular symptom and often underdiagnosed. People with dry eyes come to us with varied symptomatology. With every passing year, number of people using the visual display units is growing by leaps and bounds. Even young children are not far behind. The global prevalence of dry eyes ranges from almost 5 to 50%. Coming to our subcontinent, that is India, it's recorded slightly higher. The prevalence is about 18% to 54.3%. Patients with dry eyes can present to us with varied symptoms like irritation, ocular itching, redness, sore eyes, tiredness towards the end of the day after using prolonged hours of usage of computers, or sand, gravel, or foreign body sensation in the eye. Commonly seen in this subset of population who use computers for prolonged periods per day, you know, they can present to us with frequent blurring of vision, which clears on rubbing of the eyes. Whenever patients with these kind of symptoms present to us in our OPD, we do about the routine examination. First, we check the vision, best corrected visual acuity with the glasses. Without the glasses, the near vision is also recorded. Plus, all these kind of patients are handed out an OSDI format. OSDI stands for Ocular Surface Disease Index Scoring. It's a screening test which the patient has to take. OSDI screening test is probably the commonest and the most widely used screening test for dry eyes. Of course, there are other things like the DEQ 5 questionnaire, speed questionnaire. There are various other ones, candies. Here, the scoring pattern, we turn the leaflet around and we do the scoring. And anywhere a test score of more than 23 is termed as abnormal. Then a little detailed history is taken as to what ocular medications or systemic medications the patient is using, or are they on any kind of hormone replacement therapies. A list of all these is taken. A careful slit lamp examination is done, taking a look at the meibomian gland orifices, the external adnexa, and an IDO examination is also done. A simple in-house dry eye evaluation is done, taking a look at the Schirmer's value, the TBUT or the tear film breakup time, tear meniscus height, and ocular surface staining is done with fluorescein staining as well as with lysamine and Rose Bengal. After a complete clinical examination, we subject the patient to a tear film analysis on a placido disc-based topographer. The tear film analysis takes care of the lipid thickness layer as well as the tear meniscus height and the NIBUT, that is the non-invasive tear breakup time. Along with that, we do a infrared meibomography where the meibomian glands are imaged both from the upper lid and the lower lid. So we can take a look at the number of dropouts in the glands or the number of dilated ducts. All that can be evaluated. Whenever a patient presents to us with the symptoms of dry eye, we do a thorough clinical examination. Prior to that, we do a OSDI screening and a score is summated. Along with that, clinical examination and a dry eye evaluation is done, plus advanced tear film examination along with meibomography is also done. Finally, this all these things aid us or help us to come to a conclusive diagnosis whether it is an aqueous deficient dry eye syndrome or evaporative dry eye syndrome. Our management is basically based on the underlying pathology.